anyway, guys, before my dad starts this video, don't forget to smash that like button
and subscribe
and hit that notification bell
so that way you can be notified to see the new video.
Hi, I'm Kerry Too Smooth. If you're brand new to the channel, go ahead and click the bell to be notified. Subscribe, please. So today, I want to show you this really cool concept on the Summer Walker song called Body. And the reason why I picked this song, because it's a loop, so it gives us a little bit of space to kind of like be able to create. Now, we're not going to follow along with the same progression that's in the song. I want to show you some kind of tastefulness that you can kind of do. So in this concept, I really want to show you just some tasteful chord progressions that you can do within the movement of the song. So the song is in the key of D major. So the concept that I'm going to be teaching today, I'm going to spell it out for you now. We'll take a listen to the track and then we'll play along with the track. All right, so I'm going to be looking at this E minor 9 movement. So I'm going to start with the E minor 7 first. Doing the hammer, da, 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 off of the B string and the E string. Then I'm going to go to this D major triad, and then B minor 7. That hammer on, dun, 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 dun. E flat diminished 7. That's right. That's the movement that I want to teach you. And one of the things, like I said, in this particular song, it's just a loop, so there's nothing else to really kind of teach you. I'm not going to teach you the main progression. This is just a concept and an idea to think about as a guitarist, where we're trying to embellish without being too busy, but yet be tasteful. So that's the main reason why I picked this particular song and I'm doing this movement. This movement is not, you don't overuse it, but if you're trying to create and just trying to work on how to, you know, hear certain things and be able to kind of create around it, this is a concept of learning how to do that kind of thing. So let me walk you back through it again. We're going to start on the E minor 7, and we're going to move up to an E minor 9. To that D major triad, B minor 7, E flat diminished 7, up to the F sharp diminished 7, same kind of movement. So right, let's take a listen to the track so we can hear it play, and then we're going to go back and really show you how to use that movement over the changes, okay? Let's take a listen. Alright, so let's play along with it now with that same movement that we just learned, okay? So the main purpose of that particular exercise was just to show you how you can begin to stretch out. It's not the main chord progression in there, but as a guitarist, sometimes you want to figure out how to kind of be able to embellish it and color it up a little bit. This is a cool concept that you can practice. You can loop it as many times as you want, but what I don't want you to get into the habit of doing and thinking that this replaces what the actual progression is doing. So this is just a concept that you can try to throw out a little bit of sauce if you're playing this progression around, be like, oh, I could give a little bit of ear candy. This is what we can do. If you love this kind of lesson, please drop a comment below. And if you're just trying to learn how to do this on a deeper level, I encourage you to go to kerryscamp.com, and we have a bunch of lessons that are really going to show you how to unlock the fretboard and you'll be able to hear the changes and to know what to do in situations.